Right, Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We are at Everton Red Triangle in Liverpool today, and we've got some of the team with us here. Paul Stevenson in the middle, head trainer. We've got Nick Ball on the left and Meshach Spear, both undefeated prospects. Firstly, Paul, thanks for having us down today. A good recent outing for the lads. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, well, firstly, Meshach was on earlier in the bill against a local lad, Paul Pierce, unbeaten. It was a top performance for Meshach. Kid come out to win, come out swinging. Meshach put a couple of good body shots together and then finished with a good one on top of the head. And, you know, that was that. He got the KO. And, of course, Nick was in a good competitive fight. A fellow prospect coming through. Nick put in a blinding performance, round and a half, good work. And, you know, got a stoppage as well. Brilliant night for both lads. Both lads, in my opinion, shone on the show, really, you know, and really made a good name for themselves, I think. And two real prospects, two savage prospects, you're going to be hearing more things from in the future.
Okay, well, let's hear from a couple of them. So, Mr. Notorious, Meshach Spear, you're developing a reputation as being a puncher. You had an opponent who came to win as well. And that, I suppose, played into your hands because you got the opportunities, didn't you, in the gaps to throw the big shot. So talk us through it from your point of view.
Basically, what you said, you come to win, and I landed and he went. That was it.
Doesn't mince words, Meshach, does he?
No, let's go spits do the talking. But you got an exciting style, Meshach, so you know you are going to develop a following that way, aren't you? Like, yeah, from having an exciting style.
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
That's what people want to see, knockouts. So if it carry on the way I'm going, you know, I don't see why I shouldn't build a bigger following.
Yeah.
Meshach from the amateurs, he's had when he was at this club for a while in the amateurs, and he developed a real talent for getting rid of people fast. Mm. And now that he's back here as a pro, it's nice to tap back into that. And you know, he's someone who's hungry for the stoppage, hungry to give the fans what they want to see. Exciting style, big puncher. Same with Nick. Exactly the same type of mindset. Both lads.
But you don't always see it down at this weight.
Yeah.
The big knockouts and the big punches. But yeah. So that's actually something that goes doubly in your favour.
I mean, the big punches are rare at any weight, aren't they? But certainly in the low weights. But you. A lot goes in, doesn't it, to making a punch, yeah, but certainly having that temperament, someone who's prepared to go out there and look for it and to take it, you know, and is good at training towards doing it as well. Mm. You've got something there.
Absolutely. And Nick, going into your last fight, you were 5-0 going into it. Your opponent was 4-0 going into it, and a local derby, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's quite commendable that you'd take on someone who's undefeated at an early stage of the career, you know, at a similar stage to you. So what was going through your mind when the fight was sort of put to you?
I said yes straight away because I know what I'm capable of and what I can do. So that's what I've done. Got it done quick, got the job done.
Now, I heard you come out of the traps very fast and you looked to put it on him.
Yeah.
So what was your mindset in that? Was it something? Is it something you plan out? Is it a strategy? Or was it just you were feeling the mood that night?
No, I was calm like up until the fight, like in the build-up. But then as soon as the bell went, I just thought, I knew like I'm on a different level to him, so I just put it on him and caught him early with a left hook. Seeing he went, wobbled, and then put it on him, and then in the second round, got him out of there.
Paul, when you're matching fighters, I mean, do you have an active role in matching the fighters as well?
Yeah.
When you're looking for opponents at the stage that these lads are at, what are you looking for in an opponent and to progress them?
Okay. There's two sorts of conflicting thoughts, if you like. There's you want the lad to have rounds, you want the lad to have a knockout. You know, that you would like the rounds, the boxer will benefit from the rounds, but the crowd and the television and everyone else, you want to see the knockout. The fighter wants the knockout, everyone does. So it's ideally. Actually, it's tricky because if you've got a boxer who's 15-0 with no knockouts and you put all your eggs in the experience basket, you might have done the right thing, but who wants to watch? You know what I mean? Or you go the other way. You've got 22 knockouts with no real substance to your boxer. It's a fine line. I'm sure everyone finds. They're trying to strike it just right to get the lane of fights, but to still fights where you can still, if you've got the right boxer, still has the opportunity to shine. Fights like he's just had, like Nick's just had, they're not problematic in terms of whether you're going to get the stoppage. You're going to get it pretty much a decent fight because you've got someone who's coming to win, and it's very difficult, you know, we know what the game's like, it's very difficult breaking down someone who's living, is surviving in a boxing ring. You've got a stone in weight on you, you know what it's like, these are quite often the matches thrown at you late. And then breaking them down when they don't want to know, when they don't give you an opening, difficult. But when you get someone in there who comes to win, you get to show what you're about, and that's what was brilliant for Nick. When we were offered that match, they said, do you want to box Brian Phillips? I said, yeah, immediately, you know what I mean? It was a match in my mind, which was only really in our favour. And also knew you'd have someone there who'd come out and give Nick the chance to show what he was about. And, you know, and that, at the start of the fight, we were in the ring first. The other corner came in with a massive entourage and everything else. Nick standing there like James Bond, the coolest man in the place, you know, not bothered. Arms on the ropes.
Like Rose versus Frotch.
Yeah, he was just dead relaxed, dead chilled. And the bell went, he did his talking in the ring, you know, and what more could you want? He's brilliant.
Yeah, fair enough. And Misha, you know, every time I come up to this gym, or every time, basically I'm excited about this gym because everyone's talented. You've got a lot of talent in it. I mean, do you find that it's good to sort of bounce off all the other lads? Because basically, he must be quite competitive as well, to be fair.
Yeah, definitely. Like, we're all hungry and want to get to the top, so we all just push each other on and bounce off each other. It's a good atmosphere to be in, to be honest with you.
Nick, who gives you the best spars in the gym?
Lord, it's every spar we go at it. Like, there's no holding back. Like, we've all got like that killer instinct, and that's why we take it into the ring with us, because we spar heavy, so that's why we fight like that as well, so.
Very diplomatic. Yeah. Paul, you've trained him very well. Very, very well. What's next for the lads? What's next?
We've just got to wait and see. Obviously, for Mishak, it was just 2-0 at the minute. Getting some consistency going with his career, you know, getting him, so he's just had his first fight in a while, so he's been able to build a little fan base, so that just needs to carry on so that he can, you know, keep getting on these bills early on till he gets his record up there. Nichto's just had a really good win, and there's Central Area titles and things like that, English titles out there. Nick was a very gifted, and Mishak was as well, both very gifted amateurs. I mean, Nick was, I think, went 25 wins, 2 losses as an amateur. Only one of them to Brandon Dayard by a skinny margin. Won 3 national titles, boxed for England, you know, was a kickboxing champion when he was a kid, had 85 fights, you know, doing that. He born to it, same with Mishak, you know, the lads. So let's just see. There's some options out there which, you know, which are getting being considered now, so it's just that picking the right thing at the right time and going in with your eyes open and, you know, making no mistakes.
And if you haven't watched these two guys yet, make sure you do, as well as the rest of the gym. Big fight coming up this weekend. I did say I was going to get your predictions. I gave you a little bit of time. This video has been going 8 minutes now, so hopefully you've had a little think about this one. Big fight of the weekend in Dillian White versus Josie Parker. So obviously you focus on your own game, but I know all boxers like watch what's going on as well, don't they, in boxing? So what do you reckon is going to happen in this fight? We'll start with Mishak. How do you see the fight going, Parker White?
I can see Parker winning. I'd like Dillian White to win because he's a fellow Brit, but I just think the experience is with Parker. He's been in the big domestic heavyweight world title fight, so I'm going with Parker, points.
Parker points, right. Paul, what have you got?
Again, the Parker who boxed Joshua, I don't know, maybe he wasn't allowed to get going, but it didn't seem to get going. You know, if he, I suppose White's got a chance against that version of the man, but personally, I would imagine, you know, you've got Parker's probably the man to bet on, you know, if you want to do that.
Points, stoppage.
Yeah, points, I'd say. Points. Yeah,
Parker, yeah. Points. Yeah. Nick, are you going to go with the same or are you going something different?
No, I'm
going
to go White, not help me.
Yeah?
I reckon he's just going to catch him.
Yeah. Early, late?
6-7, something like that, yeah.
Nice, Nick. There you go, he's going against the grain.
That's it. He's his own man, aren't you?
Yeah, he's right. His own man.
Yeah.
And tell us about these new t-shirts as well, because they're looking pretty cool, these. Yeah, got a lot of sponsors on.
Yeah, these were from my last fight. I've just had a couple made. All my sponsors and that, and then my name on the back, so they're good.
Yeah, cool.
Always does a good t-shirt, Nick, achy.
Yeah.
Quality printed the loom out, Nick. Good stuff.
Yeah, they only wash twice, don't they, through the looms? No, it's important, the t-shirt game, as a boxer. All right, cool. Well, it's good times for the gym, Paul. Very good times for the gym. I mean, tell us, just before we go, give us a quick roundup on the rest of the lads, please.
Yeah, from amateur to pro this year, it's been brilliant. We've got five national champions in the amateurs, at all levels, schools, cadet, junior, senior ABA champion, Commonwealth Games gold medalist this year, Pete McGrail. One of the best years in the amateurs that we've had for a while. Obviously the pro team coming on great. Stephen Lewis and Alex Dickinson progressing really well. Mishach and Nick and Brandon Day, of course, all progressing great. There's a buzz about the gym, a strong, you know, work ethic. These lads are in here every single day, and they're really killing the training. They're going for it. And the fights coming up, I mean, a big part. It's a nice problem to have, is holding these lads back sometimes, because you know they want to do too much. Nick, you know, for this contest, he sent me a video. He'd been to B&Q, bought an axe, chopped a tree in half. You know what I mean? It's old school. It reminds me of a throwback. It reminds me of Jack Dempsey used to race dogs and chop tree downs and throw rocks. You know, it's good. I like it. So holding them back's a big thing, and making them. You know, so they don't leave it in the gym. Bit of an art to it, isn't he? But yeah, it's a nice problem to have, actually.
Very nice problem to have.
Yeah.
Well, one of the most talented gyms around, and looking forward to seeing how all the lads get on in the next fight. So, cheers for that, lads. Anything final you want to say? Any sort of sponsors we need to shout out? Anything like that?
Got them all on my top there. We can see them.
Give them a little shout. Yeah.
Give them a little shout.
Kays and Clothing, IG Coaching, Ian Gibson Coaching, the Glenbrook Hotel, Kingfisher Print and Design, Hanover Management Welfare, and SB Plasterers, and Body Fuel Liverpool.
Might be easy just to ask you, who doesn't sponsor you next time?
That's only got any, Mishak?
Not that I can think of.
Right, everyone listening, Mishak Spear needs sponsors. Get on him ASAP, because he's one to watch, trust me, get on him. Right, brilliant, okay, thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot, Aki, nice one, lads. Sam.
Cheers.
Sam.